Hey there everybody, Milknyte here, and welcome to the next part of Lego Batman. We ended up getting past the boat stage in the last part, and we are going to continue from where we left off, pretty much, through the rest of the Penguins chapter, I believe. I loaded the save from the save state, which is fine. It turns out the game did actually save, but it saved at a certain interval. I didn't have the same amount of studs compared to what I have now when I load that save up. So the game does seem to save on Melon DS. It just tends to save at specific spots at the end of levels, it seems. But regardless, I'm still going to be saving states at the end of each stage, just to make sure anyway. So, right, we're going to head into the sewers. Because that's where we're going from last time. Fun little fact today, I got to play around with the how to make a video loop on OBS today. I've been using that for my stream starting soon. I've also got one for BRB, I'll be right back, but I don't see myself using it unless there's an emergency and I need to like step away, but 9 times out of 10 if I step away from somewhere, I'm more than likely going to be offline, so. Let's see, how are we starting this stage off? Can Bruce get up there? No. The sledge can't get that way. Ah, that was a switch that I'm supposed to interact with. Right, now we have our gas mask. Get ready to hear Robin gas breathing ASMR again. Because of that, you know, it was great the first time around. Need the blast suit for that? Yes, we do. I've got a vent to go through though. Different direction this time. So we check how OBS is doing, by the way. I haven't looked at the CPU for a bit. About 20% to 16%. We seem to be fluctuating, that's okay with me. Right, blast suit time. Or demo suit. Another pushing block, I think. Yeah. Excuse me. We need Robin to get up here. There we go, a ladder for Robin. Bats can't go through there, so let's shut these off for him. Okay, we press the switches. Pulley switch. Yes, it is. Put my switch down, it's gonna go under the other. Wait for us to get out. Oh, I see, so we're putting the water back in so we can get across. It's kind of cool. Event for Robin. It's not a bad level so far. Usually sewer levels tend to be kind of bad in games, but I actually don't mind it. It's quite well designed. Things look a bit more intuitive. See, these pulley switches are a lot more identifiable because of how close they are, but the one in that one level I could not even identify it because of how zoomed out the screen was. And cue the baddies. Or baddie, I should say. There's only one dude. Where's Batman? I need him. Oh, there he is. Yeah, we need to get bats across. Grapple hook for us to get across, okay. All we need to do is blow this up. Kaboom. Hold on, there's more pieces to build, I think. Ah, I see. I need the switch. For the main door. Oops. I can do a ground slam. I just noticed that. Sort of go on a raft. Not that perspective though. I should have double jumped. That's more like it. Ladder. There we go. Time to blow this up. Let's get all the studs that I can find. Get to blast the door open. Like a pro. It just occurred to me that those symbols are Batman symbols, but they've got like graffiti on them. They're supposed to be Joker symbols, I think. It's only just occurred to me. Oh, we're gonna need Grayson for this. Both of them done. We'll go back to Bats and switch to him. Actually, can I do it through the touchscreen? Nah, you gotta be in the same facility. Oh well. Oh yeah, Killer Croc time. Not sure what his fight's gonna consist of. Other than fighting him directly, I guess. Bit of a mash fest, this one, it looks like. That's it, just an abrupt end after beating up Killer Croc. I was expecting a bit more nuance to his fight, but oh well. Not a bad little level. I liked the layout of it. I just think that the little fight with Killer Croc at the end was a little bit meh. Definitely could have done with some more caveat to it. It was just run up and hit punch him as much as possible. I mean. This is the last stage for this chapter, and then we've got like Penguin to deal with, and then I think Joker's crew comes in for the final chapter. interesting noise. Been a while since we've seen one of those. Ray demo suit again. Best suit ever. It's used so much though, for real. Not gonna notice what's going on here. Discord bloody hell. Discord is definitely a bit delayed, especially when it comes to announcements. Not actual Discord, but like my Discord server, like sometimes announces when the stream's live. It seems to be coming through later and later in the stream. I might have to look into the bot that I use. Wait, what? Oh, there we are. Now he's lined up. Yeah, I swear tightrope walking is like very finicky. Assuming this will put a platform over the bats. Platforms in this case. Assume we're gonna need the gliding suit. Maybe I can just jump at the right time. Man, they're scattering those kind of everywhere in this stage. I guess it's frozen. Can't hit it. Pretty cool level so far. I'm digging the design and the puzzles. Those. I don't know why. They do look like they're frozen, but I could be wrong. This is pretty awesome, to be fair. It's pretty ambitious for a DS port. Oh, Catwoman's back. Right, I had to blow it up with bats because it's red. Guessing the same deal as before. Pretty hard, Robin. He took forever to knock like a bad guy down. Hey, true hero. Nice. There we go, we have the diamond back. And Penguin's been foiled. No penguin army for you. Or robo penguin. And then Catwoman takes it. Of course she does. Oh, no, she didn't take it. Well, foiled her before she got away with it. Penguin goo. Game saved. I guess we're heading back to the Batcave now. Yep, we're back at the Batcave. We have to go and do chapter 3 now. Since that'll be unlocked. What I'll do is before we go in, actually we'll go in. Joker's last laugh. Let's get them studs. Oh, yep, yeah, I've not auto-saved for a bit, have I? Or rather, saved a state. Okay. Saved a state. Because we're gonna need it. Just in case. Right. Chemical factory. definitely a nod to Tim Burton's Joker. Scarecrow, Harley. Who's the other dude now? I'm trying to remember his name. Scarecrow, Joker, Harley, and there was another guy in green. Laughing gas, I guess. It's bugging me who that other guy is. So apparently that's the Mad Hatter. I just looked it up. I was actually wondering, and he was in the cartoons. He was pretty much a minor villain, essentially. Kind of interesting that they went with Mad Hatter. Fun little fact: Mad Hatter was supposed to appear in one of the Joel Shoemaker Batman movies, and apparently Rowan Atkinson was going to be considered for the role, which would have been interesting. Imagine how that would have played out. Ourselves a demo suit. Right on cue. It's going to the other side now. Try and press these switches again. They couldn't open because they had the barricade still attached. Gonna need magnetic robin to get up there. Chemical Robin first, though, his breathing mask. Whoops, didn't mean to do that. time to get the next light activated. See, that perspective works fine. I've got to get the free blue blocks. Oh yeah, I need to be Robin for that. Okay, maybe not. Oh wait, hold on. I still got the magnetic suit on, no wonder. That's where the last block is. Thank you. handy staircase. Man, they were just throwing blue studs galore there. Oh, I need the cold suit. I need Batman to get over the hell. I see. Except nothing happened. Oh, hold on a second. There was a switch there the entire time. Cold suit, been a while since we've used this, literally. The pipes are covered. Oh, there's Mad Hatter. Oh, he's got like hats with like little things on them. Oh. That's everybody use the batarang, so. There we go. No more goo for you. Bats are like, I'm gonna beat him up. And then he talks. Okay, they've just left him hanging there, that's kind of funny. Mad Hatter and the Joker who are unlocked. Right, save, because I've just done a stage. The game saves anyway, but it does actually work at just certain intervals. I'm assuming this is a flying stage we're going to be doing, or rather, the stage that the game probably has in mind is the flying stage. Maybe stage 3 will be that. We've got buggies here. It's pretty neat. Pretty creative that we're inside like a fun house. Glider suit. So we're going for a little ride. The love boat. Heck do I do this? There seem to be any actions to pull it. You just move on forward. Maybe it's like a bonus area. Oh, the direction, of course. My bad. Hello, Harley. Oh, I can glide over from there, my bad. Getting a bit confused then. Some sort of trap room. Hey, look, we got the demo suit back again. So, follow the stars, I guess. And you should be fine. Okay, through the vent we go. Holly Dunson. Oh, these ones have presses this time. So you can't dawdle. Damn it, I fell off. There we go. Now we can blast the door open. Little roller coaster. Oof. You gotta make sure I'm not anywhere near them. Bit of a different cart, I think. Get a bit faster, isn't it? Oh, she's got a mallet. There we go. It seems that throwing the batarangs at her was, like, easier. A better option. That was a fun little stage, not gonna lie. Oh, Scarecrow. Okay, let's save. Shift and F1, isn't it? I'm a little bit tired tonight. My workout took it out of me. It was a good workout, though. Always a good workout when you're feeling it, you know. What Scarecrow's gonna do. Oh, is this a flying stage? Yes, it is. Oh boy, you know how much I love these stages. Sense of what's going on. Speed up. Man, this is so disorienting. Oh yeah, we've got to touch the switches, huh? Not as easy as it looks. Probably gonna die a bunch because the screens are not properly synced, but hey, what can they do? So we've got our obligatory driving slash flying stage this time. I guess this is gonna like split Scarecrow from Joker. And we're probably gonna have a stage specifically with Scarecrow. It's gonna auto save. Is there a specific order for these? Come back to those in a minute. Ah, that's why I'm not getting it right. There's two on the other side here. We'll work out the order when we get rid of the goons. Gonna need a chemical suit for Robin. Here comes the copter. More more goons coming down. There's that infamous photo of the two people at the with the pitchfork, and that's done in Lego form nonetheless and very pixelated. To use the batarangs again. Not mini kit. Probably need to glide to get it. In magnetic rubber. These two sure love to give us the runaround. Oh. Now there's the glider. That's what we need. This is where we're gliding. Just need Grayson to get over here now. Gotta wait for bats to get over here. Pretty cool that the AI can do that. Like, they're pretty fast about it too. Alright, I guess we have our face off with Scarecrow. Oh, they're all skeletons. That's kind of cool. Fear toxin. Same deal again, I'm assuming. There we go. Defeated him. That weren't too bad. I mean, the boss fight became a little bit, kind of a moot point, though. By the time you could turn the switches back on again. Like, there was no second set of switches. I mean, if I was designing that, I would have made the first set of switches, and then, like, a second set of switches. Because otherwise, you're just running to the switches and turning on the ones you already pressed, so... Right, let's save. I think now we're on the last stage where we have our showdown with the Joker. Since he's the only one left out of the crew. We've got Mad Hatter booked, Harley, and now Scarecrow, so. And there's always one driving stage, so. The numbers add up roughly. Demo suit. Nope. I need that for Magnetic Robin. There's the demo suit. Magnetic Robin coming up. I love the little pose they do when they're switching to the suits. Need super strength for that. That'll be like for free play or something. Glider. You know, it's going to be fun when the glider comes out. defuse the Joker device to progress. Okay, that's pretty easy. I thought I was going to do some sort of mini game to defuse it. There's always one. Never device to defuse. Oh, I see. We need to demo this. Then we can defuse the next Joker device. Keep getting in the way. Should I get through the door?
Thank you.
Oh, we just have to defeat the enemies in the room, remember? That's pretty simple. I was expecting a longer puzzle for that one. Guess not. Then Robin can get up here. Pretty simple section. Very top now by the looks of it. Super strength needed for that. Was it Harley and Joker? I guess Harley escaped. There we go, shock them both. Robin doing? Man, they're sure leaning it with the shock time. Off they get to be shocked again. Thank you. Oh, there we go. Pretty simple fight, I guess. Giving the Joker shock therapy. And he lands on his head. Oh, level complete. Dr. Harley Quinzel. And there we go. That's pretty much the game done. I enjoyed this. It was fun. It had its small hang-ups, like that one stage with that block. Not being very obvious, but other than that, not really a bad port at all. Actually really enjoyable and pretty ambitious for a DS port, really. I mean, the driving stages weren't very fun, but then again, that's more than likely down to my emulator having delay between the two screens. But I guess on legitimate hardware it's fine. So yeah, not a bad game at all. It was definitely fun. Pretty short, considering that it's like, what, 3 chapters long, but you got 5 levels in each chapter, so that's like, what, 15 stages, which is not bad. Also, you get to do custom characters, and you can probably buy some more characters with the studs that you pick up. What else is there? There's probably more characters to unlock as you play through the stages with the villains. I won't be doing free play or going back on stream for any of this anyway. I'll probably do it in my spare time to get 100% completion, but I just wanted to play through the game and see where it took me, pretty much. I will be doing the second game next, I think, or at least in the future. Because I do want to play the third game. I do have the third game on PS4, but I can't play it until I've played both, really. I don't know why, I just kind of want to go in order with the Lego Batman games. But yeah, this one was enjoyable. Definitely fun. The AI was pretty smart as well with the partner AI, how they followed you and did things. I was expecting it to be a bit awkward, but I mean, at most, the only complaint I had was that Robin would sometimes block the door, but, you know, wasn't, you know, game-breaking or terrible or anything like that. And this is made by the TT Fusion crew, which is like a subsidiary side development team of TT, I'm assuming, at the time, that did handheld ports. Pretty fun game though, definitely enjoyed it. We'll see what happens at the end of the credits. Whether it'll just dump us back into the Batcave and tell us congratulations on beating the game, or maybe there's an extra cutscene at the end of the credits that plays briefly, who knows. Speaking of the cutscenes, I actually did like the aesthetic of the comic book style. For DS, it definitely lends itself better. I mean, they probably could have put FMV or full motion video, but they would have probably have to have scaled it down a ton to even put it on the cartridge, version. It would have looked terrible. So I'm kind of glad in the end that they did go with comic book aesthetic, which, you know, fits right in with what Batman is. So it's one of those really cool things. Nope, looks like that's it. Pretty much it's, whoops. It looks like it's pretty much just dumped us back into the back cave. There is one section of the game I didn't quite explore, the jail holding cell area, the Arkham Asylum. Oh, we're not done. Okay, we're definitely not done. There's more. Is this like the villains mode? Actually, we might be done. This is definitely just the villains mode, isn't it? Where you're playing the same stages, but you're playing as the villains, I think. It looks that way. Let me quickly check. Yeah, we're doing Gotham Streets, but we're playing with the villains, I think. Yes, it definitely looks that way. You're just playing the same stages with the villains. And the comic book strips are exactly the same. Everything's pretty much identical, by the looks of it. Let me skip forward. God, it takes forever to skip forward. Wish there was one button. Unfortunately, you can't skip cutscenes until Lego Batman 2, I think, where you can skip. Oh no, there's some slight differences. It'll probably have a few panels where the villains are in their stage, respectively. And I guess when you complete each stage, you'll probably unlock each villain retrospectively. Two-Face has the abilities to destroy. Yeah, they already have certain abilities installed then. There's no suits or anything to play with, unfortunately. Yeah, then we're like fighting security guards as opposed to criminals. Only characters with super strength. I think Clayface has that, doesn't he? Yeah, so you're playing for the same stages, but different scenarios, I guess, for the villains. Machimbo gets a section to eat, intersect with Bats and Robin. Yeah, we're on the street section now. Okay, that's fine. I could probably do these in my spare time. It's really just the villain stages that are around the thing. I just wanted to beat the main game more than anything else, really. It's cool that the option's there, though, to play as the villains and unlock them through the villain side of things on the Arkham Asylum. Not bad at all. Right, I'm going to save a state. And I'll probably do the rest of the villain stages off stream or something. I would do them on stream, but they're probably going to take a while. And it's not really in my biggest itinerary to do them. I just wanted to beat the main game more than anything else. We'll be moving on to the sequel next time around, I think. Right, that's pretty much going to be it for now. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll be catching you in the next one. Until then, ciao for now.